Another thing I want to discuss is the implementation of a heap. Though heaps are represented as trees, they are actually often stored as arrays. How is that possible? Well, since we know how many children each parent has, 2, and thus how many nodes will be at each level, we can use a little math to figure out where the next node will fall in the array and then traverse the tree. Let's convert this sorted array into a tree. We know that the first element is going to be the root since it's the biggest. The next 2 elements in the array are the children of the root. By convention, I insert them from left to right. However, that doesn't really matter as long as they're on the second level. Again, each level on the tree is twice as big as the one before it, so we know the next level has 4 elements. We can do this programmatically by tracking the size of each level in a variable, then doubling it each time we move to a new level. And everything left over fills in the left side of the last level. Now you're done. Just a quick note, not every array can be represented as a heap. This one could because it was sorted in descending order. In general, the numbers need to be in an order that will make sense on a heap. Storing our data in an array can save us some space. If we use an array, we just need to store the node value and index in the array slot. However, if we created some kind of node object for a tree, each would need pointers to children and parents. So we need to store values and a bunch of pointers for every element. Since the array saves us the pointers, it saves us space.